Just 3 hours until former President Trump takes the stage at the Republican National Convention in Milwaukee. It's the final night of the RNC, and Minnesota's delegation is there to watch Trump accept his party's nomination for president. John Croman is live there right now. And John, you spoke with the delegate. What's the mood in Milwaukee?
Well, the mood is very hopeful, very excited. You know, they've seen President Trump here in the arena several times this week, but this will be the first time that he stepped to the microphone since he was shot last Saturday in Pennsylvania. He's expected to speak for 80 minutes at least, beginning at 9:10 Central Time. Now, we've talked to a lot of delegates, as you mentioned, and, you know, they expect him to hit on the Republican Party's main themes: inflation, immigration, crime, that notion of America first, meaning taking care of problems at home first, only getting involved in conflicts overseas if directly and strategically beneficial to the U.S. Now, we've been checking in with delegates all week, and they're very excited about the injection of youth into the GOP ticket with the addition of Ohio Senator J.D. Vance. And they predict the momentum of this convention will enable them to carry Minnesota for the first time since Richard Nixon did it in 1972.
It sounds like he wants to have a focus on unity for the country, you know, despite all our political differences, and wanting to help all our American families grow and thrive and be successful. And it sounds like that's the vision that he's wanting to lay out in his public address tonight.
It has been widely reported that former President Trump has rewritten his speech since the shooting to make it more about unity and less about personal attacks on Joe Biden and VP Harris. So we'll see how that works out. Either way, it will be a historic night as he uses this as the launching pad to try to become the first former president to win a second non-consecutive term since Grover Cleveland did it back in the 1880s. In Milwaukee, John Croman, Care 11 News.